when it does this, it pushes air to this spot and it makes like a ramp thing and it makes it go up.
Woohoo!
With my head in the clouds and my feet on the path, we go chasing the sun and we'll follow the map. When this world got me feeling small, I'll be sure to tell my story whenever our adventure comes.
I just had this dream. I just barely woke up from the night and I had a dream of me just living my own life and then me swimming out on the beach really deep. I know how to swim now. And then a pirate ship came up and picked me up, and then I was living in a pirate ship until I was 14 years old. And then after a couple years later, there was a wood piece of the ship that fell off and we used it as firewood, and I cut it up with an axe. There was a clue inside. It said, "Beware the secrets of the seven seas." And I read it and it said, "Put your right foot in the puddles of water, put your left foot in the piles of garbage." And they're right next to each other. And then I did that, and then the ship was going down, down, down. Then it was like, whoop. And it hit down on the side. We opened the door and it was just rocks. And there was fish flopping around. And then the Shaytards found us. If you know the Shaytards. Most of you might know the Shaytards. And the Shaytards found us and they're like, "Hey, the beach house, we sended you some stuff." And they actually have. They just helped us get off because we were kind of much trapped. It was just fun. So that's my dream. It was actually really cool. I felt really awesome. And I smiled in my sleep when the Shaytards came. And it was just so awesome. That is my dream. It's pretty good.
James, what'd you make that's awesome?
A cup flyer.
Woo-hoo-hoo!
Right.
There it was.
What this does is it creates an interesting effect. It's called the Magnus effect.
When it does this, it pushes air to this spot and it makes like a ramp thing and it makes it go up.
Yeah. So it's called the Magnus effect.
The air is the ramp.
Yeah. If you've ever looked at a wing, it has a bend on the top and it's kind of flat on the bottom. What it does is it makes it so when it's flying, the air on the top has to go faster than the air on the bottom. And when the air is going faster, it actually makes it so there's not as much pressure there. It's the same as when you're driving down the road and a car goes really fast past you and your car goes like that. It's because the air pressure in between the car and the other one moves really fast and it makes it so it has less pressure there. And so you automatically go that direction. Another way of looking at it is that underwater, if you try and pull a balloon underwater, it's really, really hard to pull a balloon underwater. That's because there's more pressure because of all that water.
And there's so much air in the thing that it makes it go back up.
That's right.
So if it had no air in it, then it would just float down to the bottom.
So what this is doing is it has a round cup like that. But it also is spinning really, really fast like this.
Like
direction.
If you had a balloon and it had a hole in it, it down to the bottom of the sea, and it worked because there's
why was because because
all the air went
it would
back
be
up.
Spraying it'd be spraying the air up and then it'd be pushing it down. It's like a balloon.
Well, kind of.
It's like going up because it's air, and there's air inside these that makes it pretty much go up. The air flies out of these and makes it fly down, and it pushes it up.
Also, when you take a balloon and you pull it underneath the water, balloon will actually shrink the farther down you get. That's because there's so much pressure from the water, it'll squish the air. That actually happens in scuba diving. So when you're going down lower and lower and lower, it actually means you have less air to breathe. And a lot of people don't realize that, and that's when dangerous things can happen while scuba diving. So you have to understand that when you're in a really lower, you have less air because you're breathing in squished air. And that's another reason why you never hold your breath when scuba diving. You always have to be breathing so that you always are equalizing. Because if you breathed in a whole bunch of air down below, when you started rising, if you're still holding your breath, your lungs would get too much air in them because they'd start to expand.
What does expand mean?
get big. Like a balloon, blowing up a balloon. This is a rubber band. See that? It actually flies.
Instead of just going
because
up.
It's spinning really, really fast. Do a good one right towards the camera. Here, let me. I want to try one. You record and make sure to record it. Make sure to follow it.
Yeah.
Oh, I totally did it bad. Let me try it one more time.
Yeah.
That always happens when you try and do something.
What you want to do is let go of it. And go a little bit farther when you try and do that. Because when you let go of this part, it actually, you grab onto the cup and the rubber band is actually holding it down for you. Then you let go and it just flies off.
Okay. I don't know why it didn't work for me. So, it's because James is awesome.
Let's go outside.
Mom, there's something in here. I didn't get it.
So cool.
Okay, look.
This looks awesome. I'm so excited. I love the springtime. We can come outside again and enjoy the air. Enjoy it, the air. Woohoo!
Have you ever heard of a great grandma? I don't think she's ever been on camera before. I just want you to know.
Hi, great grandma.
Hey. Oh.
Hi. No, it's videos for our channel. It's videos for our YouTube channel.
You've got a camera all your own?
Who is it? Explain who
this is. It's our great grandma.
And what's her name? Grandma Robin.
Grandma Robbins.
She's doing good. And how old is she?
97.
Ask her.
How old are you?
How old am I?
I'm
97.
And
Renee's
stuff.
Yeah.
That's all. Yeah. She even remembers the first radio in her town.
Este says hi to all of you.
Oh. Oh.
There's Aunt Sally to their. It's their Aunt Sally. Mm-hmm. This is their grandma.
Do you like that, Mom?
So. Mm-hmm.
Does that taste good?
Mm-hmm.
It's good, isn't it? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Have you ever had a bagel before?
It's good.
I don't think so.
I don't
it's
think
good.
I probably have.
Are they strawberry bagels?
It's blueberry.
Bagels with strawberry
jam.
Or cream.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. So, you know what? She is very wet. Yeah.
That is our great-great-grandpa. Grandma. So, this is, so, I don't think she's ever been on camera. We're just gathering up in here, just playing. There's their Aunt Sally, my mom's aunt.
You know what? Do you know what my Aunt Sally used to do when I was a little kid?
What?
She would take her teeth out and show me.
Oh no.
You don't have to.
That's what my kids, grandkids will remember.
They're glued in.
Cause sometimes
they're not glued in.
They're not coming out.
Oh, no, they are coming out.
Oh. Hey, Charlie, come here. No. See, my kids don't know anything about them. So
Charlie, come here. I want to show you something.
Sometimes people will lose their teeth. Or their teeth.
They have to. You have to brush your teeth really well all
come
the
here.
Time.
I want to show you something.
Or
Aunt Sally can do a trick. Did you want to see her?
Film
yeah.
Him. You want to see my trick?
Film him.
Yeah.
Oh no, those are my teeth, huh?
What happened,
face.
Charlie?
Oh, I want to look at his face.
Charlie, what where did
happened?
What happened?
There's no teeth here, huh?
Yeah. What happened?
You've never seen that happen? What do you think about it, Ellie?
What do you think?
Cool.
Cool.
Charlie, that's why you need to brush your teeth.
Yeah.
My teeth fell out. They broke and fell out because I ate too much candy, and that's true.
Yeah.
She knows
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
And they got cavities.
Yeah.
So I didn't brush them good enough, huh?
He brought her a bagel.
And cucumbers.
Oh, cucumbers. No, it was not. It wasn't him that brought the bagel.
Yeah, James did the bagel.
James
he just brought
the bagel.
Charlie.
She'd
want
this.
Charlie.
And, she ate the whole thing. She loved
she
it.
Did. Yeah.
She'd never had a bagel before.
Well,
she ate it all.
Charlie.
She said, what is this?
I'm
and then she ate all of it.
Oh.
Oh,
that's so sweet.
That's my mom.
This is my mom.
Your dad and your mom.
And your grandma.
Yeah.
And your aunt.
Jessica.
Is that your aunt?
My Jessica.
My Jessica.
My Jessica.
I just handed this to Charlie. This is a shrimp. And he looked at it like this, and he said, it's like a snail. And I was like, it is kind of like a snail. And he looked at it again, he's like, I don't want it. It was so cute! And I took it back from him. But I just had to tell you that.
Ah, strawberry! That's more like it.
I just gave Charlie a hug, and he said, oh, I trapped a ever, which means forever. I actually had my grandma and my aunt come and visit with us. The kids are watching a pirate escape room right now. And I have my instant pot, which this is not a brand deal. I've just started using it and I really like it a lot. Here's my instant pot. I've actually got some beef, some meat in there, and some carrots. I'm trying to kind of do a teriyaki flavor or something like that. I've been eating super healthy, and I've actually started to feel so much stronger because I've been going to a personal trainer twice a week or so, and I feel so much stronger, and I'm trying to, like, lose weight, but really I'm just getting my body healthy. I'm doing a really good job. I've been also tracking my macros, which macros, if you don't know what those are, they're like the fats, proteins, and carbs in the food that you eat. And sometimes, even when you're doing everything right and but you can't lose weight, that's what you need to do. It's like the key to losing weight. But you have to kind of keep track of all the food that you eat. I don't know where Michael's at. What are you guys doing in this dirty room by yourselves?
Just watching.
Why don't we just watch My Hero Academia right now? We've been watching My Hero Academia lately, and I love that show, and I want to watch it right now because they're just playing. Shinoi's going through the copyright music, the music on YouTube, and what's copyrighted and what's not. And some of the old Christmas songs are not copyrighted, and they're perfect, beautiful songs, and she's flipping out right now. My grandma and my aunt came over, and we had such a good talk. My grandma wants to die. It's sad, but it's not. You know what I mean? Like, she's 97 years old. She said herself that every single day that she wakes up, she goes, oh, not again. I was hoping this was the day. Isn't that crazy? Oh, man. I never really know what to think about that, but we love her. We want her to stay, but she's ready to go.